Good morning, students. I am Raju. I will teach you chemistry. Hope you will be fine at your homes. So today we are going to start our first unit of class 11th chemistry. The name of the unit is Some Basic Concept of Chemistry. Chemistry ke andar kuch basic concepts ko hum yahan par study karenge. सबसे पहले फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी हैव टू डिस्कस व्हाट इज केमिस्ट्री. सो केमिस्ट्री इज द ब्रांच ऑफ साइंस विच डील्स विद द स्टडी ऑफ मैटर. इट मीन्स इन द केमिस्ट्री वी स्टडी ऑल अबाउट द मैटर, इट्स कंपोजिशन, प्रॉपर्टीज एंड स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ मैटर, बिकॉज एवरीथिंग इज रिलेटेड टू द मैटर इन आवर डेली लाइफ, इन इंडस्ट्रीज, इन मेडिसिन, ऑल थिंग्स आर इंक्लूडेड इन द मैटर. सो केमिस्ट्री ब्रांच ऑफ साइंस, साइंस की एक ब्रांच है. साइंस इंक्लूडेड थ्री ब्रांचेज मेनली, दीज आर फिजिक्स, केमिस्ट्री एंड बायोलॉजी. सो ब्रांच ऑफ साइंस विच डील्स विद स्टडी ऑल अबाउट द मैटर. मैटर विच कुपाई स्पेस, एनीथिंग विच कुपाई स्पेस इज नोन एज मैटर. मैटर अंडरगो टू टाइप्स ऑफ बेसिक क्लासिफिकेशन. फर्स्ट इज फिजिकल क्लासिफिकेशन एंड सेकेंड इज केमिकल क्लासिफिकेशन. In physical classification, there are three states of matter: solid, liquid and gas. You have studied earlier in lower classes. Solid, which have definite shape, definite volume and rigid. Rigid means which cannot change their shape when pressure is applied. So solid have definite shape, definite volume, rigid and cannot shape, change their shape when pressure is applied. सेकेंड फिजिकल क्लासिफिकेशन के अकॉर्डिंग जो स्टेट है मैटर की, दैट इज लिक्विड. लिक्विड हैव नॉट डेफिनेट शेप बट डेफिनेट वॉल्यूम, बिकॉज दे ऑक्युपाई द शेप ऑफ द कंटेनर इन विच दे आर इंट्रोड. नेक्स्ट, लिक्विड हैव द प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ फ्लूडिटी, दे कैन फ्लो. थर्ड इज गैस. गैस इज मेन कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ गैस इज कंप्रेसिबल इन नेचर, मीन्स इनको जब प्रेशर अप्लाई करेंगे तो कंप्रेस हो सकती हैं. एक लार्ज वॉल्यूम को भी ऑक्युपाई करेंगी और एक स्मॉल वॉल्यूम को भी ऑक्युपाई. एग्जाम्पल, दैट इज एग्जाम्पल ऑफ गैस इज सच एज LPG, लिक्विफाइड पेट्रोलियम गैस इन अवर किचन. नेक्स्ट इज गैस इज नॉट डेफिनेट शेप एंड नॉट डेफिनेट वॉल्यूम. सो दैट इज द फर्स्ट टाइप ऑफ क्लासिफिकेशन, physical classification in which matter is classified into three states: solid, liquid and gases according to their properties. Second is very important classification, this is known as chemical classification. According to chemical classification, matter divided into two types: pure substances and mixture. Pure substances are those substances which are made up of only one type of particles, yeah, which is made up of only one type of substances, and mixer which is made up of more than one type of substances. Pure substance again classified into two types: elements and compounds. Elements, it is the basic basic unit of the element is atoms. Same kind of the atom are present in the element, and if different atoms are present, then it form the compound. Elements can be again classified into three types: metal, non-metal and metalloid. According to the periodic table, these are three types of the elements are present in the periodic table. According to property, you have studied in 10th class, metal, these are malleable, ductile, hard, sonorous, all these are the properties of metal. Example of metal are copper, zinc, gold, iron, all these are the examples of metal. Non-metals, property different from the metals, different from the metal, bromine, carbon, chlorine, iodine, all these are of the example of non-metal. And in metalloids, metalloids are those elements which show properties of both metal as well as non-metal. Example of metalloid are bismuth, antimony and arsenic. All these are examples of metal, non-metal and metalloids. Okay students, this is all about the elements. Elements are metal, non-metal and metalloid. Now in the chemical classification, pure substance, second type is compound. Compounds are again of two types: organic compounds and inorganic compounds. Compounds can be classified into two types, organic and inorganic compounds. Organic compounds are those compounds which are mainly derived from the living things, means which are extracted from the living things. Example of organic compounds such as carbohydrate, protein, vitamins, fat, anything which is derived from the living things, which is called as the organic compound. And in case of the inorganic compound, source is non-living things. Non-living things from the earth crust. मतलब earth से इनको क्या है extract किया गया. Example of the non-living things या extracted from earth crust, these are inorganic compound. Example are NaCl. Common names are given here: NaCl, rock salt, Na2CO3 10H2O, that is washing soda, CaCO3, marble or limestone, CaO, quicklime, Na2SO4 10H2O, Glauber's salt. You have to remember all these: CaOH2, slaked lime, CaSO4 2H2O, gypsum, half H2O, plaster of Paris. And plaster of Paris absorb moisture, convert into gypsum. CuSO4 5H2O, which is blue color crystal, are formed blue vitriol. MgSO4 7H2O, gypsum. And H2SO4 is called as the king of acid. Next our is mixer. Mixer is again of two types, homogeneous and heterogeneous. Homogeneous mixers are those where composition throughout the mixer remains the same. पूरे mixer के अंदर composition क्या रहेगी, एक जैसी रहेगी, चाहे हम उसके bottom से उस material को लें या upper part से. In case of heterogeneous, the composition will be different. That is mixer. Okay students, these are the classification of matter. Physical classification and chemical classification we have discussed. Our next topic in this unit is properties of matter. There are mainly two types of the units which are present in the matter. First is fundamental unit, second is derived units. Fundamental, which are basic unit, by using these fundamental units we derive the units of some other quantities. These are called as the derived units by using the fundamental unit. These are very important 7 fundamental units, which are: first is temperature, mass, length, time, current, luminous intensity, amount of substance. Temperature, the fundamental unit of temperature is Kelvin. Mass is measured in kilogram. Length, meter. Time, second. Current, ampere. Luminous intensity, candela. And amount of the substance is measured in mole. As example of derived units, that is volume. Volume is length, breadth and height. These are multiplied, we can say that length cube. So unit of the length is meter, so it is meter cube. Density. Density is mass by volume. So unit of mass is kilogram and volume is meter cube. Force is mass into acceleration. Mass is kilogram, acceleration is meter per second square. Unit is, it is also equal to 1 Newton. And work is force into displacement. Unit of force is Newton and distance, that is meter. So our next topic is scientific notation. How you will notate the large quantity into scientific notation? It means the quantity in which several number of digits occur. Scientific notation means large decimal number into convert into the 10 raised to the power. Iske liye there are the some rules. What are the rule? First rule, if we shift decimal toward the right, agar hum decimal points ko right side ki taraf agar hame shift karana, means its side hame shift karana hai, we subtract the power. Power means 10 ki power mein utne hi hum kya karenge, subtract karenge. Isko ek example ki help se let's study. 0.000003. There are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6th digit is 3. So we can write it as like 0.3 into 10 raised to the power minus 5. If we want to remove this 0.3 also, then it is 3 into 10 raised to the power 6, because one digit is also shift from here towards the right side. So when we go towards the right side, yeah, we shift towards the right, then we subtract the power of 10. Second, if we shift decimal towards left, agar hum is side aayenge, if we shift towards the left, then we add the power. The example of this, 2 0 0 0 0 0. These are 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 and 8. It can be written as 2 into 10 to the power 8. Simply we can, it means इसका फायदा हमें क्या हो रहा है कि हमें किसी भी क्वांटिटीज के अंदर इन जीरोज को काउंट करने की जरूरत नहीं है. फिर हम क्या करेंगे, 10 टू द पावर 8 को रिमेंबर रख सकते हैं. और नेक्स्ट एग्जांपल इज 932.63, 10 टू द पावर 4. इफ वी शिफ्ट टुवर्ड्स लेफ्ट, इफ वी शिफ्ट बाय 2 पॉइंट्स, इफ इट इज 9.32, 2 पॉइंट्स हियर, सो वी ऐड द पावर 2 पॉइंट, देन इट इज 4 plus 2, it is 9.3263 is 10 to the power 6. Next example is 0.0046 into 10 to the power minus 4. If we shift towards the left, then we add power. And if we shift towards the right, then we subtract the power. If we are going, that is 0. It can be written as, if it is 0.46 into 10 to the power minus 4 already, then we shift 2 points towards the right, then subtract by 2, so it come out to be 0.46 into 10 to the power minus 6. And if we go towards the 4.6, it means we shift 3 points towards the right, so it will be 4.6 10 to the power minus 7. So a large quantity can be written in 10 to the power, it may subtract or it may add the power. If we shift toward the right, then subtract. And if we shift toward left, then add the power. Our next topic is significant figures. Significant figures kya hote hain? The figures in which almost all digits are certain. Fix honge sare ke sare digit, but one digit may be doubtful digit. This type of the figures are called as the significant figure. So there are some rules to calculate the significant figures. These rules are including, first rule is all non-zero are significant figure. Means the digits which are except zero, these are significant. Example 4.345, digit are 1, 2, 3, 4. So significant figure are 4. Second rule is all zeros in between non-zero are significant. If zero present between the non-zero, these are significant. Example 2.002. 2 0 are present between 2 non-zero digits. So significant figure are 1, 2, 3 and 4. Third rule is all 0 before non-zero are not significant. Wo 0 jo kya hai se non-zero se pehle present hai. These are not significant. Example is 0.004. 2 0 are present before non-zero. So significant figure is only 1. Fourth rule is all zero after non-zero are significant. Non-zero means 2.3. 3 is a non-zero digit. 2 0 are present, so these are significant. So total number of significant figure are 4. Fifth point is power are non-significant. If power are given 10 raised to the power something, if given, these are not significant. So significant figure are only 2. 2.3, 1 and 2. 2 significant figure is present in this quantity. If such things or quantities are given, 6 chair, 5 pencils, then significant figures are, infinite number of significant figures are present in them. So students, next our significant figure in case of addition, subtraction and multiplication as well as division. So let's start first case in case of addition and subtraction. When we add 1, 2 or more than 2 quantities, then significant figures are calculated according to the lowest places. The number in which points digits after the points are lowest, then significant figures are calculated according to this quantity. That is, example is 23.2. So after the point 1 digit is present, after point 2 digit, after point 3 digit, we add them and quantity come out to be this 290 point. Significant figure in this is 3. Point 1 is present, so it is after the place significant figure are 3. We can write it 29.0. So significant figure in this quantity are 3. In this, the main point is significant figure are calculated according to lowest places. Lowest places is 1. In this case, another example 47.04, 2.341. after point 2 digit, after point 3, after point 4 digit. So significant figure are calculated according to this. We have to only put 2 digit after the decimal. We have to put only 2 digit after the decimal. Decimal ke baad hume sirf 2 digit ko rakhna hai. Kyunki lowest places jo hai, these are 2. When we add them, quantity occurs is this. According to this quantity, 509.4. So 2 points after the decimal, so it is 50.94. It is 50.94. But last digit is 4, and after this is more than 5. It last digit is more than 5, so we add 1 in this, so it is 50.95. And number of significant figure in this are 4. Rounding off kis tarah se karte hain? Rounding off is 50.95. Isme likha hai if more than 5. Last digit of uske baad kya hai? 5 se zyada koi digit aayegi. Then we add 1, increase by 1. And if it is less than 5, then quantity, if it is there is 3, then it will remain same, 50.94. And if it is equal to 5, agar ye digit 4 ke baad yahan par 5 hota, phir kya karte? Agar ye equal to 5 hai, aur usse pehle even number hai, if it is 50.945, then it will remain same. It will remain same. And if it is odd number, then it is increased by 1. Ek example se dekhte hain, 5.671, 5.67, kyunki baad mein kya 5 se kam tha. Yahan par 5.635, yahan dekho last digit kya hai 5, aur usse pehle kya hai, ek odd number hai, so we add 1, so it come out to be 5.64. And in this digit, the last digit is 5, but before the 5, digit is even, so it will be 5.64. These are the rules for rounding off. In case of multiplication and division, if we multiply two quantity, then significant figures are calculated according to lowest number of significant figure. The lowest number in this present 2, so when we multiply it, so number of significant figure are 2. In this quantity is also number of significant figure are 2. So these are the some topics of first unit, some basic of concept of chemistry. Okay, students, we will continue our this unit in the next lecture. Thank you.